Hi, Michael Schuster here on behalf of the team of all types of professionals at Divorce Specialist Group. And as Ontario's first divorce real estate specialist, I've had many divorcing clients meet with me to sell their matrimonial home. And during our initial consultation, they often ask me if I would reduce my fees if I find the buyer who has no real estate agent of their own, and I can therefore do what's called a double end, or double end the transaction, or effectively represent both the sellers as my initial clients and then the buyer who's writing the offer. Now, this can be a very tricky situation, and there can be serious liability, well, not to mention conflict of interest, if the realtor that you hire to sell your matrimonial home actually double ends the sale and represents the buyer as well. Here's why. In amicable situations where a property is well kept, nicely staged, and priced according to fair market value, as a certified negotiator, I guarantee you that I can get top dollar for the sale, likely even set a new ceiling price for your street. On the other hand, in some divorces that sometimes become very hostile or acrimonious, and where a property might not be well kept, not staged because the sellers are fighting over who might pay the stager, or a seller might have unrealistic expectations of what fair market value might be, or they might have intentionally overpriced the property just to stall the sale because they want to stay in the property. Often the property will sell for much less than their expectations, which is why I just said in some situations they're unrealistic. In other words, it will sell for fair market value, don't get me wrong. And while I often do get clients fair market value or more, here's the potential risk in divorce scenarios such as the one I just described. If one of the two spouses thinks that a property is worth hundreds of thousands of dollars more than fair market value, or what the market and buyers think is fair for the property, then I, as the realtor, if I were to find a buyer who is in fact willing to offer fair market value, and so I go ahead and prepare the offer for that buyer, then potentially the unrealistic spouse who was expecting more, while the realistic spouse is willing to accept the offer, the unrealistic spouse could potentially accuse me of telling the buyers that the sellers are getting divorced, or accuse me of disclosing their seller motivation just so that the buyer would submit a lowball offer and hopefully that the sellers would accept. Now, of course, I would never do that. But if a spouse is being unrealistic about their own divorce, or has an ulterior motive to stall the sale of the property, or possibly has a high conflict personality or narcissistic personality disorder or other things like that, they could potentially suggest that I violated my fiduciary duties to my sellers, which of course means a lot of repercussions and can jeopardize the sale of the home, not to mention my career. So some people say it's a conflict of interest for a realtor to double end any real estate transaction. Now, I don't know if I agree with that. I do believe that some, not all, but many agents can objectively look out for the best interests of their sellers throughout the entire process while merely drafting an offer for a potential buyer. And so it's not always a conflict of interest. But that's assuming that the sellers, the two sellers, are acting as one united client, meaning two people, of course, but one united team, if you will. And obviously the potential buyer is the other side of the transaction. But in hostile or high conflict divorces, or where one spouse might have unrealistic expectations, or narcissistic personality disorder, or simply be using and leveraging the real estate transaction to stall the sale because they don't want to sell, or they're in denial and they don't want the divorce, or if the other spouse is paying the bills so they're effectively living there for free, often what they might do is use the realtor or accuse the realtor of doing something wrong just to stall the sale of the house. So, in order for me to be equally fair and open and honest with both of my sellers who really aren't united with each other in their thinking or their expectations, so the sellers and the seller's agent should not try, in my opinion, to double end a sale if it's a divorce sale where there's high conflict, just to save a few dollars. In fact, here's what I do when these situations arise. While I'm one of a very small, select few realtors in the GTA who truly have specialized skills and knowledge in helping people selling a matrimonial home in divorce, I do have a great rapport with one of the other real estate divorce specialists I know here in town. So to ensure a fair and honest and smooth transaction for my sellers, if a potential buyer came to me while I was representing and listing a property for my sellers, I would refer that buyer to the other realtor I know and respect. That way, the seller's motivation would never be disclosed. In fact, I wouldn't even tell the other realtor that I know my clients are getting a divorce. I would never do that. But this would ensure that everyone was treated fairly and honestly and above board. If you have any questions or want any information about selling your matrimonial home in divorce or hiring a realtor or any other type of divorce specialist to help you through your divorce, Divorce Specialist Group does have the best divorce real estate specialists and family lawyers and divorce coaches and financial experts and all types of professionals. They're all highly vetted, highly trained with a proven track record of success. I've had the privilege and honor of working with many of them. So if you have questions, just email us with any questions you might have, or you can also request a free 30-minute consultation and we can talk about your situation. Everything is always strictly confidential and there's never any pressure or sales pressure or sales obligations. So just send us an email, info@divorcespecialistgroup.com. Thanks for watching, and we do wish you well.